And my brothers and sisters in Christ, grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. So, Les Mis, if you are not a fan of it before this morning, surely you are now with a lovely musical selection in front of us like that. It's hard not to be. But if you are a fan of musicals, you probably already know it, or maybe you are a lover of world literature, and you, which I'm impressed with if you've read it, the novel of Les Miserables, upon which the musical is based, is a behemoth of a novel. According to Wikipedia, good source for all things, it has 655,478 words in the original French. It is a big slog to get through, but one of the longest novels ever written and one of the world's most significant novels ever written by those who are deciders of such things. But a story that continues to have significance and meaning, in which we find good words and words of grace and mercy, and continues to be relevant a century and a half after it was written. However you know or don't know the story of Les Miserables, here's a recap. It's a French historical novel set in France, beginning in 1815 and ending with the Paris uprising in June of 1832. It's a challenging time in the world and in France. It's a time of the haves and have-nots, where there is a big, vast, wide chasm between the two. And the tensions are high between those who have much and those who have little. And life is particularly hard for those who are the have-nots. And they are stuck often in the streets with poverty and disease, often forced into terrible decisions in which they must choose between life and death. And if they choose life, they are also often forced to lose in that choice their integrity, their honor, and their dignity. And the haves, well, the haves sit comfortably in all that they have. And the tension between the two has all the makings for a revolution, and thus the uprising at the end of the novel. One of the have-nots in the novel is Jean Valjean, who at the beginning of the story is a prisoner, where he has been for the last 19 years. We heard some of his story in the choir's musical selection, but he's been in prison for 19 years, five of those, for stealing bread. For his sister's child was dying and they were all starving, and so he stole a loaf of bread. 5 years for that offense, and then because he kept trying to escape prison, another 14 tacked on along the way. But he is finally getting out. And upon his release, Inspector Javert, who has been overseeing his imprisonment, gives him the news that he's going to be released. He says, "You are going to be released. Do you know what this means?" Jean Valjean says, "Well, it means I'm going to be free." Inspector Javert says, "No, it does not mean you are going to be free. You are going to be paroled, for you are a thief, and I will be watching you." And Jean Valjean feels the weight of the law upon him. And Javert sends him on his way, not by his name, but by his prisoner number, 24601. "My name is Jean Valjean," Jean Valjean says to him. "No," Javert says, "you are 24601. In Javert's eyes, Jean Valjean is just a bad seed. Which our parents warned us about. We ought avoid, right? Avoid those bad seeds in life, because some people just are. I remember when I moved to a new school in the first grade, not only a new school, but a new community, and I remember when I did that long time ago, but those moments sort of stick in your brain because they're big moments in life, aren't they? And I had moved from a school that, my new school was four times the size of my old school, so it took some laying of the land to figure out. And as I watched my classroom and tried to figure that out, I saw pretty quickly that there was this one kid who just seemed to get in trouble all the time. One of those bad seeds, right? The kind of kid my parents might have gently suggested, well, maybe not hang out so much with that kid. If someone was going to get in trouble, it was going to be him. And it continued, not just that first year, but every year. It seemed like there he was again. New class, new year, but getting into trouble again. Bad seeds. Over the years, though, I started to wonder if it was actually him doing something or if it was just his reputation that got him into trouble. Seems like once we think we know someone, well, then we think we know, right? If someone is good or bad, good seed, bad seed, and then we interpret all those actions accordingly. Javert, the inspector who followed the law to the T and demanded the same of the rest of the world, could see that this Jean Valjean, prisoner number 24601, was just a bad seed. In the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus is traveling around and is preaching and teaching and healing. And how he does this often, the preaching and teaching anyway, is through parables, stories. And he tells this parable that we heard read this morning, this parable about a farmer who sows good seed, that is, the seed that he wants, the seed that he needs to grow in order to have a harvest. But the enemy, well, the enemy comes along and sneaks in the cover of night and sows other seeds, weeds. And now they're both growing. And so the farmer lets them both grow and knows at the end one will be kept and one will be thrown in the burn pile to be gotten rid of. One harvested and kept, the other discarded and burned. If you continue reading in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus will go on to explain this parable. What does it mean, his disciples say and ask? And Jesus will say, well, the bad seeds are the evildoers and the sources of sin in the world, and those in this category will be thrown into the fire, and there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And the good seed, well, the good seed, that is the wheat that grows and produces fruit, well, that's harvested and stored in the barn. Well, those, Jesus says, those are the righteous ones, the ones who belong in the kingdom and are gathered into the kingdom. Which are you? Sometimes it's hard to know, isn't it? Many years ago, when my daughter was in elementary school, we were on our way to a volleyball practice one night, to which we were running late because I always run late. And so we were cruising along and I'm pushing the speed limit, but somebody else must have been running late as well, and so they were cruising along beside me and went up in the one lane and then quickly got over in front of me. And I'm one of those types who, as I drive, I narrate, drives my kids crazy. But I said, oh, she just cut me off. And so my daughter in the back seat, who had been, you know, just blissfully looking out the window and observing life, had been observing this car as it was beside me and coming up along, and she said, no, not that car, she's too pretty. When it's left up to us to figure out the world, right, our eyes often deceive us. And we think when we look out in the world and we see someone with a beautiful life and the outer trappings and everything looks good, we just assume that that's one of the good ones in life, right? Not only good, but they must be doing good. And then when we see a life that's not so good, even ugly, full of chaos and mess and stuff and hard things, we might think, oh, there's one of the bad ones, right? Left to ourselves, we kind of wonder and can't figure it out all the time. I mean, how good are we at figuring out this seed thing? Anybody's bracket blow up yesterday in March Madness? When the number 16 seed takes out the number 1 seed, I mean, what do we know anyway? When Jean Valjean is released from prison, he goes with this yellow piece of paper, which he immediately discovers limits his life, boxes him into this identity, tells everyone that he's a bad seed, not to be trusted, not to be hired, not to be given a place to live, not to be given a chance. So he's left out on the streets, which is the only place for him to go. And there, out on the streets, he is found by a bishop who gives him shelter and food, and whose kindness he repays by stealing some of his silverware. If a thief is what the world is going to call him, well, why not be one, right? A name is not always just a name. When he is caught and brought by the police back to the bishop so the bishop can confirm that the silverware found on him does indeed belong to him and therefore he is the thief that the police think he is, the bishop acts mercifully, saying that the silverware found on him was given to him. And oh, by the way, Jean Valjean, you also forgot to take these silver candlesticks with you in your rush to get out the door this morning. I had more for you. He tells the police to release him, which they do. As they leave, the bishop then gives even more to Jean Valjean. He gives him some more words. See those words and hear them on the screens.
But remember this, my brother. See in this some higher plan. You must use this precious silver to become an honest man. By the witness of the martyrs, by the passion and the blood, God has raised you out of darkness. I have saved your soul for
the darkness you are raised for your soul, the bishop proclaims, speaks, preaches, for your soul, Jean Valjean, belongs to God. Belongs not as in beholden, but belongs as in loved, treasured, valued, belongs. And in words of grace given and heard, Jean Valjean finds his life, in which he is seen not as a thief, not as a number, not just a bad seed, but as a soul which belongs to God. As Jesus tells this parable about good seeds and bad seeds, our tendency as human beings is to hear this and wonder about us. What am I? And what will I be judged? And we look around our lives for evidence to see if we can tell, because we cannot help but wonder what we are and how we might be judged. And God gets this about us, that our human hearts have this tendency to look at ourselves and not know, and that our human hearts have this tendency to listen, well, what does the world tell me that I am? And we listen to the names that they provide and the titles that they bestow or do not bestow, and then our human hearts take that in and we think that we know, and then we have a tendency to get it all mixed up. Weeds, which is which, and till we don't know the difference, or there's a piece of wheat in the midst of weeds and we think that it all should be thrown out, and what's the worth of saving the one when it's in the midst of the rest? Or worse yet, we think we do know it, and then we think it's our harvest and not God's. But Jesus, he does not fear the weeds, and he does not fear the judgment, and he does not fear the sin and death, because he has put those things in their place on the cross, leaving them behind and revealing them to have no power over those whom God declares are his. Jesus knows that the weeds cannot make the good seeds bad. The weeds cannot make the good seeds bad. When the bishop declares to Jean Valjean that he is not lost but found in God, this declaration, this good news, these words of mercy are not dependent on Jean Valjean going on to redeem himself, but they are the words that actually redeem him. The promise of God that is given to you is not an opportunity for you to do good. It's a declaration of what you are, that is sinner, redeemed, that is one who is forgiven, that is one who is claimed in God, one who is declared good seed. not dependent on you or anything you do or not do, but dependent only on God's word proclaimed to you and made final in the cross in Jesus Christ, crucified and risen. And what God declares to be good seed is. And to whom God declares this is you. And to whom God declares this, my brothers and sisters in Christ, is you. You, who through no doing of your own, and all through the doing of Jesus Christ, are the righteous that is a part of the kingdom, that is the good seeds, whose souls belong to God, and in this, not paroled, but free in Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God. Amen.